I'm sorry, man.
I didn't even know his birthday was
November 11th. November 11th.
Huh?
November 11th.
10 November.
10 November, damn it. Fucked up the eye holes a little bit, but
3 hours ago, pain.
Wow. About the tongue.
That's right. Cut her off after. Stay on. That's all I do.
Left a little fur on there, but
that's all right.
Yeah.
It's not bad.
Do you want the legs or?
Nah. I just want to cut them off. You can stick them in the fridge. Thank you.
Yeah.
I always have wishes for making that on the 8-pocket bait.
Yeah.
So when you put them in the tote in the fridge,
yep.
Take the rat that's in the tote and just throw it away because I didn't cut the legs off.
Greasy.
Yeah.
medium board's blue, correct?
Yeah, so wipe your gloves up first.
Definitely meat on the gloves.
Yeah, I always just try to check that before I'm gonna board it. Just stand the board on. Take it off. Hold it by the nose. Hold the fur by the nose, yep. And you're just gonna shake it onto the board. But you're not ready to board till you flush it.
Oh yeah. Thanks for that lesson.
Once you finally get it skinned, the first thing you do to remember is to put it on here so it's out of your way to clean all your equipment. Yeah. So see all that fat over the, that's a good winter wrap. And I, for some reason, I always just hold that. I don't know why, it's just habit. Just always goes down, never try to go sideways. But it's that armpit and that arm. Yeah. So you do want to try to get that little thicker thing.
Okay.
You'll know how much pressure you need to start getting fat off. And then you got to get that white fat. So you can go pretty. So turn the spoon a little bit. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
That's how much pressure. See how it's coming off now? A lot of guys afraid to tear it. It takes a lot to tear it.
But.
And especially once you start trying to break this saddle.
Yeah.
So what I do is I start on one edge of the fat on the saddle and then the top edge, and then I connect them. I don't try to go all the way upward. I try to go to the top now and work through the fat. Pushing against the fat with the spoon. You got to break. There it goes.
Yep.
And you'll connect that open. You'll open that fat all the way across. Nope, just keep working the fat.
Yeah.
The saddle will come down on its own. And then you just go slowly. Because once you start seeing all the fats coming out, the white.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. So, and then before you fluff it. So you want to take what's on the top of the saddle off too after. So now you've done that. So now go under the saddle that you've got curled over. And that takes a little more effort to get off. Yep. And now when I'm at that point, now I keep holding the spoon. Just use the back of your knuckles and flip that saddle up with your hand. Like the back of your hand. Yeah, that's what I do.
Okay.
Yep. Just because you'll forget, and it dries easier when it's back up like that. And if you want it, when it's winter fat, you might want to just take that ball, just pull it down onto the board and just throw it in a paper towel so you're not chasing it the whole way, because a lot of times it just stays detached.
Yeah. It's a workout.
Dude, that's my fucking shoulders what fucked me. That's what fucked me, was my shoulder.
Yeah. There's no way you're doing this with a bad shoulder.
No. Don't do the belly yet. You're just doing under that arm.
Okay.
You're not doing the back or the belly. You're doing... So take your blob off first. You always want to keep a clean board. No. Leave the paper towel always. Don't bring it down. So just use a spoon. Scoop it with your spoon and your finger. Yeah. And now you've got to work this ridge of fat. You'll feel it in your spoon. So don't go to the back. This is the back. Hold. Yep, like that. There you go. Now you'll feel it. And if your spoon keeps snapping over a spot you're trying to do, it's because there's a piece on your spoon, and it's not cutting the fat. Yeah. It takes a lot because it's little thick pieces. But that's all you're trying to get off is that edge. You'll feel it with the spoon. You'll feel it like squeeze. Like through it, and you'll see it. Yep, just right there. And if you got little pieces that hang, try not to get onto the flesh. Try to just hit it with the edge of the spoon where the fur is, and it'll cut it. The same thing you're doing, but just try to hit it with the spoon, and it'll cut it off. I try to go like that, and you'll end up hitting it once, and it'll cut it off. That'll take forever if you just try to push it, pull it, and it may not even come off. It's just going up, 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 up. We'll get it. You probably have a piece of fat on your spoon and it's not cutting. See, that little thing will stop the edge of the spoon from cutting. predict it. I just go 1,000 times like this till I hit it. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it may not come off. It may just be a part of the flesh, but I try to get it off. But if you can't, you can't. Yeah. And then you just, to keep that, I just lift it and turn it. All the way to the other, lift the whole face off from there. Yeah. Spin it till you see that arm in the center. Pull it down, and then I grab these two and pull down a little thing. That's a lot of fucking winter fat, boy. Hands you can take that fat, and hey, it's just like mink oil, and put it on your leather boots.
Really?
And it waterproofs. Oh, yeah. So Mac tells me, so with muskrat, it probably takes 6 to do, to get a repetitive, you know, the routine.
Yeah.
It takes 6. So Mac tells me doing beaver, to do a beaver right, 1,000. Skinning 1,000 beaver before anyone would ever tell you you could do beavers.
Wow.
And I'm at about 400. And I think I do a fucking... Mac cuts his fucking beavers all the time. I've never cut a pole in a beaver. Never skinned it. Ever, ever, ever. And I skin flat on a table, and he skins in a trough horse.
Yeah.
Everyone does in a trough horse. I don't.
Yeah, but it's an old one.
Midway USA scope and rangefinder package. 6 Sawyer scope and rangefinder 100 package deal.
How much is...
Everything from Midway USA.
Should see if they can get you a credit card.
Nothing worse than having a fucking extra large rat dude, a giant, and stuff. You've done everything. You've skinned it.
Yeah.
Hey, and you're down to the very end of flushing, and it fucking tears open from a big bite mark it has on its back. I mean, like, tears open 4 inches. You're like, motherfucker, I just took my time doing everything. When I do, like, my fox and fisher and all that, I feel the animal with latex gloves on with scars on it.
Yeah. Back is before belly?
Yep. And there's pretty much usually nothing on there. You're just kind of looking for a piece of meat that was stuck to your hand when you spun it. I tend to look at the saddle again and make sure with the back of my hand I flip the saddle all the way up when I'm looking at the back. So that's what you're doing. You're looking for a piece of meat that's stuck on there, or sometimes it might be a piece of flesh on the tail end of the back that got stuck on it.
Yeah.
And the belly, remember, that's the thinnest part. Really no fat other than around the sex organs and on the inside of the hips.
Just a couple of little pieces. probably going to be 70 degrees and sunny.
65 and sunny, so we can do it outside.
You have a barbecue out here?